What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we're going to do another NBA Prize Picks board breakdown for February 3rd. It's almost 12 o'clock here on the East Coast. So if you're seeing the projections in this video, seeing them on Prize Picks, Roto Grinders, well, they change throughout the day. So just be cautious of that before you go and lock in any picks or lineups. I missed you guys yesterday. It was the first time since launching the channel that we did not shoot a video. I had some business to take care of. Wasn't feeling so great. So, you know, you got to do what you got to do. You got to take care of business and you got to take care of yourself. But we're back today. We're going to get back on track. Excuse me. Allergies. I played Russell Westbrook last night and it did not work out for me whatsoever, guys. He pretty much sunk most of my lineups. Felt very good about him. He was not agreeing on our premium Prize Picks spreadsheet, but I ignored that and I said I'm gonna roll with it anyway. The chat, everyone in the Discord decided to roll with it too. Well, not everyone. The guys that didn't roll with Westbrook in the Discord channel, well, they did really well. Go check Winner Circle channel in the Discord and you'll see what I'm talking about. A lot of money being won for all the premium members out there. If you want to join the Discord, there's a link down in the description below. If you want to subscribe to the channel, I'd appreciate it. Turn on notifications because I typically post a video every single day. So I don't want you to miss out on any of the content that we talk about here. But enough of that. We've got a 10-game slate, so I don't want to talk too much business. I want to talk more projections, but we got to talk injuries first and foremost. And the first guy on the list here, Russell Westbrook, is doubtful. He's likely to be rested on a back-to-back. Kemba Walker, doubtful. He's likely to be rested on a back-to-back. Steven Adams, questionable with a calf injury. PJ Washington, out with a foot injury. Terry Rozier, questionable with an ankle, right ankle sprain. John Wall is out due to rest. Karl Anthony Towns, out due to COVID protocol. Andre Drummond, questionable with a back issue, lower back soreness. D'Angelo Russell, he's questionable due to a quad contusion. LaMarcus Aldridge is out due to a flip hexer or a hip flexor, however you want to say it. SGA is out with a knee injury, so that's a pretty big one there too. Marcus Smart out, DeAndre Hunter out, Larry Nance out, Wendell Carter out, Patrick Beverley out, George Hill out, and Kevin Love is out, but that's it. That's it for the injury news. Let's move on and start talking projections here. The first game we have on the Prize Picks board is the Philadelphia 76ers taking on the Charlotte Hornets. We got a number of big names we could talk about here, but let's talk the biggest of them all, Joel Embiid. He's projected for 50 points tonight against Charlotte. That game tips off at 7:10 p.m. Let's head over to Roto Grinders and take a look at where they have Embiid projected. They like a slight under on him tonight at 49.38. Let's open up his recent game logs and see what Mr. Embiid has been up to. In his last game against Minnesota, 57.7. Then he got a 42.2 against LA. He missed that game against Detroit. Four games back against Detroit, he played that one and put up a very good 57.3, 53.7 against Boston, and a 65 against Boston as well. I don't see a game log in his recent games here against Charlotte, so let's move on and talk minutes. Joel is expected to play 33 minutes tonight. He's a versatile big. Versatile bigs against Charlotte, they've done well. The Hornets, they only rank 24th against versatile bigs. Not afraid of the matchup here. He should be pretty well rested. No back-to-back situation or anything. Playing just under 32 minutes a night. Good minute total there. 1.6 fantasy points per minute. Super impressive number there. The highest amongst all centers. And 31.79 usage rating. So he's very involved when he's out on the floor. You love that fantasy point per minute and usage number for Embiid. Now let's talk game total and spread here. Charlotte, the home team, 107.5. They are the underdogs against Philadelphia. Philadelphia, a 7-point road favorite, 114.5. So you're talking about a 7-point spread. That puts this in an orange range for me. Kind of like be cautious here because this game does have a chance to blow out. You're going to want to probably just take first half only on some of these guys in this game. I would be very cautious trying to pick any of the stars to go over, especially if it's projected to be one of those blowout type games. So there you have it on Embiid. They like the under, and I kind of agree with that, especially if you're taking full game format and this has a chance to blow out. So let's move on to the next guy. Gordon Hayward, 38 is his projection tonight. Going over to Roto Grinders here and seeing where they have Gordon Hayward projected. 36.45. So they like the under on Hayward tonight. Let's take a look at his recent games and see what's up. 34.7 against Miami. 41.6 against Milwaukee. 33.6 against Indiana, 25.2 against Indiana, and a 43 against Orlando. So you can see in his last five games here, guys, he has went under tonight's projection of 38 once, twice, three times. So three out of his last five, he has not hit tonight's projection of 38. I like the under on Hayward just based on that, but let's dig a little deeper as we usually do. 37 minutes is his projected total tonight. Versatile forwards against Philadelphia have struggled on paper. This is two games and three nights for Hayward. He's playing just under 36 minutes a night, putting up over one fantasy point per minute at 1.06, and his usage rating is 24.47. So not bad, but I wish it could be a little bit higher for a guy like Hayward. So there you have it. This is another situation where the under looks like the play, and I agree, especially if this game is expected to blow out with a 7-point spread. There is a lot of risk, I would say, at taking any of these stars and taking the over on them in full game format. So there you have it on those dudes. Let's move ahead to the next game. We've got the Indiana Pacers versus the Milwaukee Bucks. That game tips off 7:10 p.m. on PrizePicks. We'll talk Domantas Sabonis. Took him last night on his single stat for points, and he absolutely crushed. He hit his single stat for points over in just the first half of play. He had a very good night scoring the basketball. So let's take a look and see where they like him for fantasy points tonight. Sabonis is projected for 43.88, which would put him under his projection of 45. Let's look at his game logs and see what he's been up to. I told you last night he had a really good game. He shot 13 for 15. That is a very efficient scoring game. Ended up with 58.1 fantasy points. The game before that was a letdown, 29.1 against Philly, 40.2 against Charlotte, 48.2 against Charlotte, and a 15.6 against Toronto. Now, looking at his game logs here, there's no games against Milwaukee yet. So we're going to move ahead and talk minutes. They like him to play about 37 minutes tonight. He's a post-up big man. Post-up bigs against Milwaukee have eaten this season. Milwaukee ranking just 25th in the league against post-up bigs, so we're not afraid of the matchup here. This is a back-to-back, however, and three games and four nights. Fatigue could play a factor. Keep that in mind. It's minutes per game, over 36, 36.7, 1.2 fantasy points per minute, and 24.41 usage rating. So pretty good numbers there for the Indiana Pacers big man. Let's talk game total and spread. Milwaukee at home, 120.25 versus Indiana on the road. They're the underdogs, 112.25. So this is another game that is in that orange, maybe even creeping into the red side of things for me, because Sabonis has played a lot of minutes lately, back-to-back, three games and four nights, plus the spread, 8-point spread. I think there's some risk here at playing a guy like Sabonis and taking the over. So just be very careful in full game formats. If you want to play it safe, go first half only and probably take the over on a guy like Sabonis, who you know is going to put up big fantasy points per minute and be very involved for the Indiana Pacers. Now, skipping ahead here to the Milwaukee Bucks. Giannis Antetokounmpo, 55. That seems to kind of be the number for him lately, 55 fantasy points. He's taken on Indiana. Let's take a look and see where they like Giannis tonight. 52.85, pretty big under. Even if we round it up to 53, that puts him 2 points under his projection tonight on PrizePicks. Looking at his recent games, 33.8 against Portland, 69.1 against Charlotte, huge game, 66.7 against New Orleans, 60.1 against Toronto, and a 53.8 against Atlanta. As you can see here, no game logs recently against Indiana, so let's skip ahead and talk minutes. He's going to be playing about 34 minutes tonight, maybe even less, guys, if this game blows out and it's in hand by the first half or early in the third quarter. This game could be, you know, a runaway for the Milwaukee Bucks. Versatile forwards against Indiana. Indiana ranks 13th. not an easy matchup, but if we're talking guys that are matchup proof, it's Giannis Antetokounmpo. He's matchup proof. There's not too many teams in the league that are going to slow a talent like him down. Two games in three nights for Giannis, playing 33 minutes a night, 1.57 fantasy points per minute, the highest fantasy point per minute average amongst power forwards on the slate tonight, and his usage rating, 34.18. So very elite usage, very elite fantasy points per minute. Another situation here where I would probably play the first half and take the over on Giannis based on his fantasy points per minute, based on his usage, and based on the potential that he may not get a full run of minutes tonight if this game is a complete blowout. So that's how I'm feeling about the Greek freak. But let's move ahead here and talk the next game. We've got a superstar duel here. The Dallas Mavericks, Luka Doncic versus the Atlanta Hawks, Trae Young, Luka and company. That game tips off 7:40 p.m. That's PrizePicks time. PrizePicks is usually like 10 minutes later than the actual tip-off for whatever reason. But Luka, 53 is his projection. It seems awfully low for a guy who can give you 60-plus on any night, but tonight on Roto Grinders, they've got him at 51.95. Let's round it up and call it 52. 52, so that would be a slight under on his prize picks projection. And if you look at his last five game logs, you can see why the under might be the way to go. 51 in his last game, 45.1, 43.7, 42.8, and a monster. Huge game here, 82.2. These 82.2s aren't going to happen very often, as you can see in his game log here. It's the only time he's ever put up 80 or more fantasy points, which is just absolutely ridiculous. But looking at the game logs here, I don't see any game logs against Atlanta, so let's move ahead and talk minutes for Luka. 35 is his expected total tonight. He's a combo guard. Atlanta ranking dead last. Dead last in the league against combo guards. So this is a very juicy matchup on paper for Luka Doncic. Two games in three nights, 34.8 minutes per game, so just under 35 minutes, 1.53 fantasy points per minute, the highest fantasy points per minute average of any point guard on the slate, and his usage rating is just shy of 36. This is elite usage rating. This is elite fantasy points per minute mark for Luka Doncic. Let's see if this game is projected to stay close. Well, the home team is the Atlanta Hawks. They're expected to score 111 points. Dallas is a 1.5-point favorite on the road. The game does look like it's going to stay close, which you love to see. And I expect that both of these guys who were drafted in the same draft class, Luka and Trae Young, will be looking to put on a show against one another and prove who is the best young point guard in the league of the two. So let's talk Trae Young, the other half of this equation here. Atlanta Hawks point guard taking on the Dallas Mavericks, as we mentioned. His projection tonight, 46 points. His projection over on Roto Grinders, 44.08. Let's round that down and just make it an even clean 44. That would be an under tonight. If we dig into his game logs, 52.8. That's a very big number. 50.1, 52.6, a 49.1. We have a blank here against Milwaukee, so let's go one back and talk 48.3. So pretty good numbers in his recent game logs. He's been hovering right around that 50-point mark on any given night. So tonight's projection of 46 seems to be well within reach based on his recent five games. No games versus Dallas in the log, so let's move ahead and talk minutes. 35 minutes. They consider him to be a combo guard, and combo guards have struggled. At least on paper, this is a very tough matchup, the toughest matchup on paper for Mr. Trae Young. Dallas ranks first in the league against combo guards. This is two games in three nights. He plays over 34 minutes a night, and his fantasy points per minute are pretty good here, 1.28, and his usage is very, very good, 34.69, elite usage rating. The only person with a higher usage rating is the aforementioned Luka Doncic. So this could be a duel. This could be a shootout of two of the game's best point guards. Should be a fun one. So there you have it on Mr. Trae Young. Let's move ahead to the next game. We've got the Los Angeles Clippers versus the Cleveland Cavaliers. Let's talk Kawhi Leonard. He is projected for 47 fantasy points tonight. That's a heck of a number. But if anyone has the talent to do it, it's Kawhi. But it looks like on Roto Grinders, they like him to go for 44 and a half. Let's just round it up. We'll call it 45. But even at 45, that would fall short of his prize picks projection of 47. In his last few games, 64.5 against Brooklyn. That was a heck of a game there. 42.3, 33.3. You've got two blanks in a row there. A 56.8. And 5 games ago, 56.6. So in his last 5 games, guys, he's went over tonight's projection 3 out of 5. 3 out of 5. So not a bad number there. Don't have a game log against the Cavaliers. So let's move ahead and talk his minutes tonight. 34 minutes. He's a versatile forward. On paper, this is a middle-of-the-road matchup, we'll call it. Not difficult, but not easy. It's a back-to-back for Kawhi, 3 games and 4 nights. 34.4 minutes per game, so pretty decent minute total. 1.37 fantasy points per minute. That is the best figure amongst all small forwards. And then 28.65 usage rating. Pretty good there, too. Looking at the game totals here, Cleveland, the home team, 105.25. They're the underdogs. The Los Angeles Clippers, 112.75. I'd put this one probably in that orange zone where it looks like the way more talented team in the Los Angeles Clippers could definitely make a real blowout of this game. I think this game could blow out. So you know what to do. Take Kawhi Leonard in first half formats and take the over, or take him in a full game format, but I'd probably lean toward taking the under as this game looks like it could be a runaway. All right, now let's skip ahead to the next game. We're going to leave Andre Drummond out because he was on the injury report, as we mentioned at the top of the show. I'd rather not waste my breath on a guy that may not be in the lineup. So let's talk the next man up, and that's Colin Sexton. Colin Sexton projected for 34 fantasy points. Let's see where they like him here on Roto Grinders today. Colin Sexton, you are never a point guard. You're always a shooting guard, aren't you? Yep. His projection is 31.2. So that's a pretty big under based on his prize picks projection of 34. And his last few games, 32.1, 16.4, 23.7. So he's went way under, guys, way under in his last 3 games. He has a big one here, 43.5 against Detroit, and then another big under, 29.8. And the dude is playing some pretty heavy minutes, 29, 34, 34, 31, 41. So he's getting the time out on the court. He's just not doing a whole lot with it. So based on what I'm seeing here, the under looks like the way that I'm kind of leaning, but let's go a step further, shall we? 35 minutes is his total tonight. He's a combo guard. Clippers ranked 12th in the league against combo guards. 3 games and 4 nights for Sexton, playing just under 35 minutes a night. Good minute total there. We just need him to be more efficient. And this is where that efficiency comes into play. His fantasy points per minute, under 1. So that's not very good. Our gold standard here is like 1 or better. That's what we typically look for from these basketball players. Well, he falls underneath that 1, but his usage is pretty good. 28.07 on the usage rating. So there you have it on Colin Sexton. If it's a blowout, maybe Colin Sexton sits. This is a tough matchup. He hasn't been playing very well lately. I don't trust taking an over on his 34, but every once in a while he digs into his bag of tricks and he could put up a big performance. So play him at your own risk. Oh boy, the Prize Picks website is malfunctioning. Let's wait for it. Let's see if it fixes itself. This is awkward. This is awkward. I'm not reshooting this video. I promise you that. Let's refresh the page. All right, we're back. I think we're back. Let's keep moving along here. I don't know what that was. Prize Picks, fix your website, fix your app. It does some weird stuff from time to time, as you just witnessed here on this video. But on to the next game, guys. We got the Miami Heat versus the Washington Wizards. This game tipping off at 8:10 p.m. Prize Picks time. Bradley Beal. I like Bradley Beal tonight because it sounds like Russell Westbrook's going to be sitting out in this one. So let's go and look at Bradley Beal's projection tonight. 52.06. He's got an incredible streak of 30-plus point games going right now. Real-life points, not fantasy points, real-life points. So the over kind of makes some sense, especially without Russ Westbrook in the lineup. Let's look at his recent game logs. 44.4, kind of a downer. 48.2, 40.9, 69.8. That was a monster game against the New Orleans Pelicans. And then a 43 against Houston. So in his last five games, he's got one game where he's went over tonight's projection of 51. But again, with Russ out of the lineup, this guy is going to have free reign to score as many buckets and shoot the ball as much as he wants to. Because we know if Ish Smith starts for Russell Westbrook, he sure as heck ain't going to score the ball. He's not much of a scorer in his, we'll call him the twilight of his career here. So I expect Bradley Beal to have the green light. And let's talk minutes. 38 minutes, he's a scoring wing. Scoring wings against Miami. Miami ranks third in the league against scoring wings. Tough matchup on paper. Brad Beal, back-to-back, three games and four nights. He's playing a tick under 36 minutes a night, putting up 1.40 fantasy points per minute. He can really fill it up as far as real-life points, and he does it with fantasy points, too. He's the highest fantasy point per minute shooting guard on the slate. And then his usage is also the highest by far amongst all shooting guards. 38, guys. 38.12. Bradley Beal might have the highest usage rating in the entire league. I'll have to research that. But let's talk about the game totals and spread here. Miami, 119. Washington, 111. This is an 8-point spread. So there is danger. Danger, danger. Let's call it orange, creeping into the red, orange-red. As far as blowout risk here, there is some blowout risk with an 8-point spread. I'm kind of leery about taking the over on Bradley Beal despite his projection of 52.06. We'll dig in a little further on the spreadsheet. If you're a premium member, we've got a kick-butt spreadsheet that's been printing money almost every night. Very, very accurate. It had all the top players right yesterday except for one, Rudy Gobert. Three nights ago, it had every single top projected player correct. So, I mean, it's doing work, guys, and it's well worth $20 a month. So you should think about doing that. But anyway, let's move ahead and talk Miami Heat basketball. I want to talk Jimmy Butler because I like Jimmy Butler. I think basketball is better. The NBA is a better product with Jimmy buckets in it. And so I'm happy to have him. 41 is his projection tonight. 41. Let's see where they have him here on Roto Grinders. They've got Jimmy Butler at 41 as well. 41.79 to be exact. So we typically round that up. Let's call it 42, a slight over, slight over. In his last two games, guys, you can see he has absolutely smashed his projection tonight of 41. Can he do it again? Three games in a row, 52.3 and a 50.4. No previous game logs of recent against Washington. If I go all the way back here, though, down to January 9th, almost a month ago, he put up 60.5. 60.5 versus Washington. So you take into consideration the 60.5. You take into the consideration here that he's put up 50-plus in two games since returning after this long three-week layoff. And I really like the Jimmy Butler over tonight. I mean, it seems like it makes a lot of sense. Pending, he gets enough minutes before this game blows out. Hopefully, he is the reason that it blows out because he's going absolutely ham on the Washington Wizards. You hope that if it does blow out, it's because of Jimmy Butler. Anyhow, he's projected to play 33 minutes tonight, scoring wings against Washington. Feast. This is not a tough matchup whatsoever, guys. Bradley Beal is interested in one thing and one thing only. That's offense. He doesn't care about defense. If these guys are matched up, Bradley Beal's probably just going to try and outscore Jimmy Butler here. This could turn into a little shootout. It would be fun to watch. Two games and three nights for Butler. He's playing under 31 minutes a night, putting up 1.33 fantasy points per minute. And his usage rating, 27.18. Very good usage, very good fantasy points per minute. Jimmy Butler is an excellent player. I don't need to tell you that. You probably already know that. So, in a full game format, it's hard for me to take the over just because I know that this game has blowout risk, but definitely feeling good about a first half only over on Jimmy Butler. That might be like the closest thing to a lock. I don't talk locks a whole lot, but this is looking really good, guys. Consider it. Consider it. All right, moving ahead. New York Knickerbockers versus the Chicago Bulls. We've got Julius Randle up on the board at 44. The New York Knicks, big man, has had a pretty good season. Kind of cooled off in recent games, and I think the game logs will reflect that. But we're going to talk about him right now. His projection tonight is 44, as I mentioned. In his projection on RotoGrinders is 42.88. So even if we round up to a 43, that still puts him 1 point under on tonight's projected points on PrizePicks. So let's look at his recent game logs here. 47.7, that would be good for an over. 45.9, that would be good for a slight over on tonight's projection. Then he had three games here, under. And then the 41.9 would be under as well on the 44. So out of his last five games, he's only got two games where he's went over, and it happened in his last two. So you can kind of get an idea of how Randall's been playing. Now, he did play Chicago here in the last one, put up 47.7 fantasy points. So that's kind of a good sign, right? It makes you feel kind of confident that maybe an over is within reach for Mr. Julius Randle. But let's look at minutes, 36 minutes tonight. He's a versatile big. Chicago, pretty soft against versatile big men. Three games, four nights for Julius Randle, playing over 36 minutes a night, healthy minute total. 1.21 fantasy points per minute, good number there. And his usage, 27.09, so well over that 25 that we like to look for on the usage rating. That's very good usage for a big man like Randle. Now, if we look at the game totals and the spread, Chicago, the home team, 109.5 is the favorite by 3 points over the New York Knicks. So there's a 3-point spread here. This is green for me. This is not blowout risk. This is not anything that I'm worried about. It's a pretty healthy amount of points to be scored from both teams, and the spread is looking very good, very, very good. So if you want to take Julius Randle over, you can do that. RotoGrinders thinks he's going to go under. So if you're a premium member, we'll dig a bit deeper and compare, you know, six different sites versus PrizePicks so we can really land on the right play for Julius Randle. But let's talk Chicago Bulls basketball. Zach LaVine, 42 is his projection tonight. Let's see where he's at on Roto G. 39.73 would put him under. Let's look at his game logs. 33.5 in his last one. That was against New York. Keep it in mind. Fell way short of his fantasy projection there. 40.4 against Portland. 41.7 against Boston. 35 against LA. And 49.7 against Charlotte. So in his last five games, guys, he's struggling. He's struggling to get over that 42 mark. He missed here. He missed there. He missed there. He missed there. He's only went over 42 one time in his last five games. Let's look at his minutes tonight and see if we can find out if the over, the under is the way to go. 36 minutes tonight, so good, healthy minute total. He's a scoring wing. New York ranking number one in the league against scoring wings. Got to love that if you're thinking about taking an over on LaVine. Well, this is a tough matchup, and it kind of lends itself to the belief that LaVine will go under. Two games in three nights, playing over 35 minutes per game. 1.19 fantasy points per minute, and his usage is almost in that elite status of 30 or more. Just under it, though, 29.75 for LaVine. I think I agree with RotoGrinders on this one. PrizePicks is probably a little too high on LaVine. Yes, he does have tremendous upside. Yes, he does have very good fantasy points per minute and usage totals. But he struggled in the last game against New York and really has struggled in his last five. So I'd probably lean toward the under and agree with RotoGrinders and their projections on this one. Skipping along, moving ahead. We talked SGA, who is probably not going to play. Probably not going to play, so we won't mention him in this video. Let's talk Victor Oladipo. He's got an updated picture here on PrizePicks. They finally took him out of that old Indiana Pacers jersey. Slapped him in that black and red of the Houston Rockets. I like that. 42 is his projection tonight. Over on RG, they got him at 42.55, putting him slightly over his PrizePicks projection. Let's see what he's been up to in his last few. I think I took the under on Vic in his last one against OKC, and it ended up working out for me. I believe Houston ended up getting, did they get blown out or did OKC get blown out? I don't remember, but I remember there being a blowout. I remember Oladipo came out hot out of the gate. We were all sweating. We were like, dang, he's going to go over tonight, isn't he? Well, something happened and this dude slowed way down and didn't even come close. Didn't even come close to sniffing 40 or whatever his projection was for the night. But anyway, 39.7, 46.9, 24.5, and going all the way back here to January 22nd, 23.9. So at 41's looking kind of steep. It's looking kind of high for, or 42 rather, even more steep. That 42 has only been eclipsed one time, and that was against Portland. So tough matchup here. You see what he did against OKC in the last one, 30.1. That's a rematch game for him tonight. Of course, no SGA. Maybe that no SGA helps Victor Oladipo. And John Wall being out, maybe that helps Victor Oladipo. Some things to keep in mind, right? His minutes tonight, 35. He's a combo guard. OKC ranking 8th against combo guards, so it's a tough matchup. Two games and three nights for Vic. 32.6 minutes per game, 1.14 fantasy points per minute, and a 28.75 usage rating for Oladipo. Oladipo. And then, this game here, OKC 106.75, the home underdogs. Houston 114.25. So the spread here is probably an orange for me, orange range. There is some risk that this game does blow out, especially if there's no SGA for OKC. I just don't think they're going to have enough firepower, enough talent to stay and keep up with the Houston Rockets. So if this game gets out of hand, the over on Oladipo looks like a solid move. Let's skip ahead and talk OKC side of things. Not going to talk SGA, as I mentioned. I guess the next most exciting or popular player for OKC will be Al Horford. The talent really drops off after SGA, unfortunately. Well, let's talk Big Al. He's been in the league forever. This dude is super old at this point. Somehow, though, he's still kicking. He's still around. He's hanging in there. I think he's the center maybe on FanDuel. We use FanDuel projections because they're the same as the projections for PrizePicks. There he is. 33.53 is his projection right now, which would put him way over this 29. So I think RotoGrinders has already adjusted their projections to make up for the loss of SGA tonight. So the over on Al Horford looking very, very good according to RotoGrinders at the moment. Just something to keep in mind. Let's open up his game logs. 32.9, 38.2, 49.2. Guys, he's doing very well lately. He's went over this 29 easily in the last three games. And then you take SGA out of the lineup, and Al Horford should go over again, even if he doesn't play a ton of minutes. He doesn't have to play a ton of minutes. 29, 23, and 25, he put up these totals here, 49, 38, and 32, respectively. So thinking I'm liking the over on Al Horford until PrizePicks catches up and adjusts his projections. But tonight, 29 minutes, he's a versatile big. Houston ranking 12th against versatile bigs. This is two games and three nights. He's playing just under 27 minutes per game, putting up a pretty good 1.08 fantasy points per minute. And his usage is 19.71. So not the best, but we know, you know, big guys, they don't have to always have high usage ratings in order to be productive fantasy players, because they can rebound, you know, they can block shots, they can get those little easy buckets under the hoop. They don't have to be ball handlers, they don't have to be facilitators, they don't have to be the Nikola Jokic's, the Joel Embiid's of the world. Al Horford can get there, in my opinion. So there you have it. Let's move along. Oh man, PrizePicks, your website, I tell you, it's glitchy today. I don't know what's happening. Next game, though, Minnesota T-Wolves versus the San Antonio Spurs. 8:40 p.m. is the tip-off. D'Angelo Russell. This guy has been a passenger on the struggle bus lately, guys. He has been struggling. But let's see if he can get over or under his projection tonight. Well, they've got him at 30.99. Of course, we're going to round that up to 31. He's questionable for tonight, so keep an eye on his health status. 29.4, 25.7, 21 in his last three games. Terrible. If we go back even further here, 15.4 and a 37.4. So in his last five games, he's only went over this 36 once, and he hasn't went over in his last four contests. So yeah, I don't really like the over whatsoever. If we go all the way back to January 9th and 10th, we've got two games of him versus the San Antonio Spurs. In the older game, 33.6. In the newer game, 39.5. So he split there on tonight's projection. He went over once and went under once. Let's look at the minutes. His minutes are pretty light. 30 minutes tonight, not a ton of minutes projected for D'Lo. He's a combo guard. Combo guards against San Antonio. San Antonio ranking 18th, so not a terrible matchup. Not the easiest, though. Three games and four nights, over 30 minutes a night. Forgive me. 1.09 fantasy points per minute. And 30.69 as far as usage goes. So very good usage number there. Fantasy points per minute, It's okay. It's not elite for a guy who's pretty much been the number one option for the Minnesota T-Wolves for much of the season, with Karl Anthony Towns out of the lineup for the most part. You would think D'Angelo Russell could be crushing, but he doesn't do that very often. So there you have it on D'Angelo Russell. Let's move along. Prize Picks, your website is doing things that really throw a monkey wrench in this video. It's frozen again. Let's try to reload, refresh. Sheesh. Okay, technical difficulties. We're back. We're moving. Maybe they're updating the projections right now. Maybe that's why they're screwing with the website. Who knows? But we're moving on to the next game. We won't let whatever's going on stop us here. We're almost to the end. I promise. The Phoenix Suns take on the New Orleans Pelicans. The top guy for the Phoenix Suns on the board tonight is Chris Paul. Let's talk CP3. He's projected for 40 tonight. And if everybody's healthy in this lineup, I feel like 40 points is a bit too high for Paul. But let's see here. 39.75 on RotoGrinders. If we round it up, well, that's 40. So that puts him right on the button there for 40. Look at his last two games. This guy is a monster in his last two games. 59.3 against Dallas. 59.6 against Dallas. Do you think that this guy gets up for big games like LeBron James? I've talked about him in the past. Like, he just kind of rises to the occasion. I think he does. Look at that against Dallas, against Luka Doncic. He really stepped up. Look at this game back here against OKC, his former team, 44.5. You can see what he's been up to in his last few games, guys. He's crushing that 40. He's went over 40 four out of five times. I don't see a previous game log here against New Orleans. Don't forget, this is going way back, you know, for some of you young people out there, but Chris Paul, back in the day, was a New Orleans Hornet. He was a New Orleans Hornet. They're playing at New Orleans tonight. I don't know. I'm just saying. I'm just throwing it out there for you narrative folks. Maybe there's something to that. 33 minutes. He's a pass first point guard. Yeah, the New Orleans Pelicans, they rank 28th against pass first point guards. Not a tough matchup. Two games and three nights. He's playing almost 33 minutes a night. 1.12 fantasy points per minute. And his usage is 24.39. But those numbers have been much, much better in his last couple of games. Looking at the game totals and spread here, we've got New Orleans as the home team, as we mentioned, 109.5. Phoenix is the favorite at 113. So you're talking about a 3.5-point spread here. Not worried about a blowout whatsoever. I'm confident in Chris Paul. And if you're thinking about playing him in a full game format, well, I think that's safe to do. First half format, definitely in play as well. Now, backing up a spot here, we're going to talk Zion Williamson. 40 is his fantasy projection over on Prize Picks tonight. Let's take a look at Zion and see where they like him on RotoGrinders. They got him at 39.77, which would be, if we round up, a tie with Prize Picks at 40. Okay, so let's look at the game logs. 40.6 against Sacramento, 39.4 against Houston, 46.3 against Milwaukee, 44.4 against Washington, and 40.7 against the Minnesota T-Wolves. So in those last five games, he's went over his projection of 40 tonight, 4 out of 5. And the one that he fell short, he put up 39.4, which is like, you know, one free throw or one extra rebound or one block or one assist or one of anything, a steal, you name it. He would have went over there. So I really like his chances of going over tonight. Now, if we look at his minutes, he's projected to play 35, is a versatile forward. Phoenix ranking 11th against versatile forwards. This is 2 games in 3 nights, putting up nearly 33 minutes a night, 1.17 fantasy points per minute, and his usage is at 27.39. So good numbers there for Zion. The game's going to stay close. I like him to go over in this one. That's just my first look off the top without doing any additional research. So that applies to everybody I'm talking about in this video. I dig a lot deeper for the premium prize pick members than I do in these videos. I just don't have enough time to talk about everything I want to talk about without making the video 2 hours long. I know you guys don't want to sit through that. It's already 40 minutes and we're still not done yet. So the final game though, guys, the final countdown. We've got the Boston Celtics versus the Sacramento Kings. We're going to talk Jason Tatum, who seems to be back up and running at full speed. 48 is his fantasy points projection. Tatum on Roto Grinders is at 48.82. That would put him over. That would put him over Prize Picks projection. And his last game against Golden State, 38. Going back to 2 games ago, 47.3. 3 games back, 45.4. And a 37.3. So the 48 is pretty steep based on his last 4 games here. Even if we throw in this, you know, 5th game way back here in January 8th, almost a month ago. Yeah, he's only went over 48. Zero times. So why is he so high tonight? I don't know. I don't see a game log against Sacramento though. He's looking to play 37 minutes tonight, is a versatile forward. Not a tough matchup for Tatum. This is a back-to-back, 35 minutes per game, 1.24 fantasy points per minute, and his usage is over 30, so that's a very good number for his usage rating. We love to see that. We know Tatum is heavily involved for the Boston Celtics when he's out on the floor. Now, looking at the game totals, this is one of the highest projected totals on the board here, so that could play a part into why he's projected so high at 48. Look at that, Sacramento, the home team, 112.25. Boston, the visitors, they're the favorites, 114.25. So it's a high-scoring game. It's only a 2-point spread. And we know Jason Tatum has a very good fantasy points per minute and usage rating. So even though he struggled in his last few games, there's a chance, just due to the fact that this is looking like the highest-scoring game with one of the best spreads on the board, there's a chance that he can get to 48 or more tonight. So there you have it for Tatum. Now, the last guy we're going to talk about, we're going to wrap this video up with De'Aaron Fox. His projection tonight is 39 for the Fox. Over on Roto Grinders, they got him at 39.5, which would be an over. If we rounded it up to 40, that would be an over. His last couple of games have been very, very good. 57.8 against New Orleans. Huge game there. 44.2, another big game. He had a downer against Toronto. Toronto's backcourt, though, pretty tough defensively. One of the toughest backcourts, in my opinion. 41.6 against Orlando, 4 games back. And then 42.1 against the Knicks 5 games ago. So in his last 5 games, guys, he's went over the 40 mark, or the 39 mark. 4 out of 5 times. 4 out of 5 times. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 out of 5. So that's very good. I don't have a game log of Fox versus Boston. But let's move ahead and talk minutes. 36 minutes tonight. He's a combo guard. Combo guards against Boston. Boston ranking 9th against combo guards. This is 2 games in 3 nights. 32.3 minutes per game for him. 1.17 fantasy point per minute. And his usage rating, elite, 31.23, one of the best on the board for point guards. So there you have it. Very high scoring game, very good spread. What more can you ask for? This guy, De'Aaron Fox, heavily involved. We know that. So this could be a situation where you take an over on De'Aaron Fox. You know, that's my first instinct, my first look. So there you have it, guys. That's going to do it for today's video. Who are you liking? Is there somebody I mentioned in the video that stands out? Is there a projection versus roto grinders that you're really loving. You're going to click that over. You're going to click that under on. Drop that name down in the comment section below. Let me know if you're liking the over or under on them and why. I like to hear your thoughts. I like to have thought-driven analysis and decision-making, and that's what we're going for on this channel in the Discord. So that's going to do it. This has been CJ for Out of Bounds. Let's get back on track tonight and build the bankroll. You guys, good luck. Let's win some money. Peace.